Welcome to the universe of energy. How are you? No need to answer. You know, you're probably surprised to see me here, aren't you? But then there's probably a lot of places you'd be surprised to see me when you think about it. If you were driving in your car, for instance, okay? Close your eyes, you're in your car. Don't close your eyes in the car, but right now, think about it. You're in your car, you're driving, and then all of a sudden from the back seat, I just pop up and go, hey! You just whack me in the head, wouldn't you? That wouldn't be nice. But then it wouldn't be nice for me to do that to you. How'd I get in your car anyway? Did you lock the car? Maybe it was your fault. Maybe I'm just teaching you a lesson. But the point is, to see me here as a spokesperson for the universe of energy, I mean, that's crazy. You know, I mean, I'm an expert on a lot of things. You know that. I know that. But not a lot of things. A few things. But energy. I mean, there was a time I could care less about it. And then suddenly everything changed. One day I was sitting in my apartment. I said I was sitting in my apartment when... There it is. I don't think it's been snatched, but she... I mean, I can't hear me. Hey, hey, you! How about sharing some of those chips? No, you're on a diet. Me? How about you? Anyway, I'm watching TV and my favorite show is about to start.
This is Jeopardy!
Yes! Totally was my favorite show. What is... Who is it? And of course, no one locks their doors in New York.
Hey, it's your neighbor, Bill Nye the Science Guy.
Hey, Bill Nye the Science Guy, it's Ellen, the, Just Ellen, I guess. What can I do you for?
I'd like to borrow some aluminum foil, a clothespin, and a candle.
Another hot day, huh?
Actually, I'm working on a new experiment.
Take whatever you need. I don't want to miss any of the game.
What are you watching?
Jeopardy.
Yes.
A professor of energy at Princeton University, Dr. Julie Peterson.
Oh, my gosh.
What?
It's my old college roommate, Judy Peterson. She was such a smarty pants know-it-all. I had the best nickname for her, though.
What was that?
Stupid Judy.
Ellen, that makes no sense. She has a PhD.
I know, but it made me feel better. So now I guess she's some hotshot energetic professor.
She's a professor of energy.
Whatever. Who cares about stupid Judy or stupid energy?
Ellen, energy's the most important thing in the universe.
Oh, yeah, sure. Take her side.
I'm not taking her side. It's just that without energy, nothing would go. Nothing would happen. I mean, there'd be nothing.
Well, then we'd really be in jeopardy now, wouldn't we?
Yeah, well, what is, thanks for the supplies, and see you later.
What is, bye-bye.
It's the Parliament of Israel.
What is the message?
Right again. Go.
Right again, Judy.
U.S. Constitution.
Stupid Judy, stupid energy. Maybe the universe needs energy, but I don't. I'll take a nap for 100.
I know. Big piece of corn right there in the teeth. How could you not see? I'm going to have to call you back. Now, as most of you know, when someone falls asleep watching TV, that person is going to have a what?
Dream.
Anyone?
Dream.
Anyone?
A dream sequence.
That's right, ma'am, a dream sequence.
Right. Mine was more of a nightmare, actually. And actually, we should get some fog in here. Always nice to spice up a dream sequence with fog.
From water, fossil fuels, fusion, and finally, gas. Ellen, since this is your dream, we'll let you make the first selection.
I will take fossil fuels for, let's go for 100.
Fine. The answer is, this was formed from microscopic plants and animals trapped in ocean floor sediments millions of years ago. Ellen.
I know that one. That's stuff trapped microscopic fuels and plants and animals and
Sorry, Ellen. We were looking for something more than just an embellishment of what I had already said. Anyone else? Judy.
What is petroleum, Alex? What is bituminous? What is solar thermal conversion? What is hydroelectric? What is helium?
And so, as we come to the end of the first round, ladies and gentlemen, Judy has the commanding lead. Ellen has her work cut out for her, and Dr. Einstein is nowhere, relatively speaking.
A nightmare or what?
Oh, Ellen, your first correct response.
Wait a minute. Brains! This is my dream. I'm in control now. I could still win. I still have a chance to.
Ellen! Ellen!
Who is it?
It's me, Bill Nye the Science Guy.
Hey, I'm glad you came to help me.
Actually, I came to see Einstein.
Wow, you're getting clobbered.
Yeah, this Nightmare Jeopardy version's a lot harder than the home version. Can you help me?
Sure, but first we have to go back.
Back stage?
No. Way back, like many billion years ago.
Okay, but can we stop at a mini mart or something and get some snacks? Because I have a tendency to get hungry after a couple of billion years.
No can do. Time's a waste. Come on!
It's not even over. It gets really weird from here. Now some person I don't even know reminds me there's no eating, drinking, smoking, or flash photography allowed in my dream.
That's right, Ellen. There's no eating, drinking, smoking, or flash photography inside your dream.
And no videotaping, okay? And those of you who are just walking in right now, you're late. Where have you been? I love your hair. No, not you. No, I mean, it's all right, but that's cute, yeah. Anyway, so you're not completely lost. Here's a recap of what has been going on. I'm Ellen. Hi. I love Jeopardy. I used to not care about energy at all until I had a nightmare that I was on Jeopardy and all the categories were about energy. Oh, don't I know it's scary. So my neighbor, Bill Nye, stepped in to help me out. Bill Nye, the science guy. You know him? Anyway, so he comes in to help me out. That's what's going on. Got it? Good. If you don't, then that's your problem because you're late. And you think about that next time.
And now, let's return to Ellen's dream.
Please stay clear of the open door. They are closing immediately.
Why is it so dark?
Because there's nothing to see.
Let me get this straight. You brought me back billions of years so you could show me nothing?
Sort of, but out of this nothingness, many scientists believe the universe was born.
Must have been a big delivery room, huh?
See that single point of very hot, very dense matter? It contains all the energy of the universe, and it's about to expand at an astonishing rate. Here. Better put these on. Hearing protectors. Because it's the Big Bang.
The piggy bang?
No, the Big Bang.
The ding dang?
The Big Bang.
Oh.
Now what you're about to witness took place over billions of years. Where did you cover?
All right, universe, you're clear to take off. Come on. Go.
Thank you. 220 million years in the Earth's past, give or take a day.
Bill, I know I asked you to help me with this energy stuff and everything, but I was kind of hoping you'd show me a slideshow.
A slideshow? I guess that'd be easier, but this is way more fun.
Yeah, this is fun. Where's the energy?
Oh, it's all around you. See, these plants and animals are soaking up energy from the sun. When they die and get buried, time, pressure, and heat will cook them into the fossil fuels we rely on today, like coal, natural gas, and oil.
Wait a minute, you're telling me that we're filling our gas tanks with, well, with dinosaur soup?
Well, not exactly, but dinosaurs did live when fossil fuels were developing in the Earth. Dinosaurs are just cool. Let's check them out.
Why don't we just skip to the air conditioning and jacuzzi period, huh?
Alan, it's a chance of a lifetime.
It's the chance of 100 million lifetimes. Come on.
You go ahead and make sure it's safe. I'll wait here, okay? You might as well go too. This is my nightmare. No need you staying with me. Maybe I'll go. What am I so scared of? It's just a dinosaur. What's the big deal about dinosaurs? They're not so tough. Probably have a brain the size of a pea. I hope you're not upset about that pea brain crack. Because, you know, now that I think of it, I'm sure peas are much larger in this time period. I happen to love peas, don't you? I'll take that as a maybe. I should get going because I'm supposed to be dinner. I mean, half dinner with friends. So I should go. Hey, what's over there?
Thank you. Maybe that comet will help get rid of them. Now, here's the traffic update. We've got reports that a giant elephant, a Dinotherium to be exact, has pumped his trunk and is jackknifed in traffic. Plus, we can expect lots of traffic at the local watering hole as the mammal population continues to boom.
KNRG News Time, 1 million BC. And now to the sports report, live from the Mastodon.
Mammals dominate the Earth. Mammals dominate the Earth. The big dinosaurs have been shut out. They're back, extinct. The big dinosaurs have left the planet. The mammals have shut them out in a major planetary upset.
This is KNRG News Radio. Hey, let's check out the weather report and see if it's going to stay way cool outside. Willard?
Hey, we're following a massive cold front extending from the Arctic region all the way down to our planet's midsection. Now, we're urging all mammals to evolve into their winter wardrobe because it's going to get chilly. Be sure to develop a thick, furry hide if you want to make it. How cold it is.
Keep your dial tuned to KNRG for continuous news updates. KNRG News Time. 900,000 BC. Now let's check out what's happening in the wild world of fashion.
Mammals are getting hairier. That's right. Woolly is definitely in, whether you're a mammoth or a rhino. And saber teeth seem to be a growing fad in the cat world. Also, look for antlers to be very big this year, as big as 10 feet on creatures like the megaloceros. Wow. And that's the latest in the fashion world.
Is it ever going to warm up? Let's find out with a look at the weather. Willard?
You know those giant glaciers we've all gotten so used to? Well, they're going to be receding to the north and south poles. Conditions are looking very favorable for a whole new kind of mammal. KNRG News Time, 750,000 BC.
And that's our KNRG up-to-the-minute news report. Now back to our regularly scheduled program. Now we're exactly where we need to be. All we need now is Ellen.
Bill? Bill?
Ellen? Oh, there you are.
Yeah, here I am. Yeah, look, you know, it's not like I don't like getting attacked by a snake-like creature. It's just...
See, we're at the dawn of the human age, and one of our ancestors is about to make an important discovery, one that will spark the progress of civilization.
Let's hope it's deodorant.
Thank you.
the sun. It's where most of our energy comes from. And it's at the heart of some bright ideas for tomorrow.
Like what, Bill Nye the Science Guy?
Like solar energy. Solar mirrors are one way to convert the sun's energy into electricity.
Cool! I mean, coolly hot. Or hotly cool. So why don't we just make everything solar?
Not so fast. For one thing, it's not sunny enough everywhere. And although the sunshine is free, solar electricity still isn't that cheap. But it's getting there.
Okay, in the meantime, let's just pick another category.
All right. Today, we're using the clean energy of moving air, wind, to generate electricity.
Well, then why don't we just get a bunch of wind farmers to harvest a big old crop of wind?
We're starting to, when it's windy. But remember, to power a whole city, you need a whole lot of windmills.
And when the wind stops blowing, we'd be left in the dark, wouldn't we?
No way, we just switch to another source of energy.
Isn't gonna give us energy when we need it.
No, but this big gray wall might. It's clean and efficient.
I know this one. Come on, quiz me.
Okay. Hydroelectric power plants convert the energy of falling water into electricity and are renewed by this natural resource.
What is really?
Correct.
So we just build more dams and our energy problems are solved.
Not quite. We've already used many of the best sites. And sometimes building a dam can be pretty hard on an ecosystem.
Seems like there are pros and cons to every one of these. What gives?
Well, Ellen, there are no easy answers. The sun, water, geothermal steam, even wood all contribute. Right now, these renewables provide about 10% of the world's energy. But we can expect them to be playing an even bigger role in the decades ahead.
That's great, Bill, but we still need a heck of a lot more energy. Where is it coming from? And do you have a curling iron?
Come on, I'll show you. Let's hitch a ride with the solid fossil fuel.
Oh, I know this one. What is coal?
Correct. And we've discovered 2 centuries worth.
Whoa! What about global warming?
It's a hot topic with lots of questions. But it's one of the big reasons scientists are working on ways to burn fuels like coal more efficiently than ever. Ellen, what do you know about gas?
Well, if your stomach's bothering you, I could get you some club soda.
No.
Oh, you mean natural gas.
It's clean burning. At the rate we're going, we're set for about 60 years.
60 years? That's only 10 more years than 50. 20 more than 40. 30 more than...
Don't worry. We're always finding more natural gas all the time. But we do need to use it wisely. So, Ellen, how long have you been driving?
Sorry, pal. Alrighty, what's next? Oh, what is black gold, Texas tea, swimming pools, movie stars? What is the Beverly Hillbillies? I mean, what is oil?
Right, it's our main source of energy, and we found enough to last at least 50 years.
That's all?
We're far from running on empty. We've got some pretty far out ways of finding more. Satellites are one of the tools we use in our search for hidden deposits, but there are others.
Really? You know... Houston, I think we have a problem.
That's because many of the easily reached petroleum deposits have already been tapped.
Hello?
Most new discoveries will come from once inaccessible or hard to reach places. Actually, the oil is buried way deep under the ocean floor.
Oh, well, then I guess we can't get to it. So, where to next?
Oh, hey, don't give up. We can reach the oil with offshore drilling platforms like this. Going in. Dive! Some drilling platforms are so tall, they would tower over the Empire State Building. I mean, that's big!
Oh, great. Just what my nightmare needs. Big old human munching, bone crunching, Ellen lunching shark. Take her up, Captain! Rise! Rise! Where are we now?
The world of atomic power! See, today we take atoms like these and split them apart to release energy. It's called fission. Hold on! Nuclear energy is expensive and highly controversial! Lots of choices for the future. Maybe even unlock the power of the stars. Fusion power.
I'm beginning to see the light.
Actually, I think it's double jeopardy, Ellen.
There you are. Where have you been?
The beginning of the universe. There were dinosaurs, and I was in the bathroom. There are no more paper towels.
Yeah, right. 10 seconds there. Could we get Ellen to the set, please?
Well, you've been absolutely amazing so far. Slowing wave components here.
Well, my IQ is 210.
But I'll tell you something, Judy. The thing that really amazed me was that you and Ellen were in the same class
yes,
at school.
We were actually roommates. I used to call her stupid Ellen.
Okay. All right, players, we're ready to begin the second round. And Ellen, will you start us off by making a selection, please?
I sure will, Alex. I will take dinosaurs for 800.
Ellen, you do know that the more expensive the question, the harder it is.
Oh, no, I didn't. Let me rethink that then. Dinosaurs for 1,000, Alex.
Okay, the answer is, this is when scientists believe dinosaurs first appeared on the Earth. Ellen.
What is 220 million years ago, give or take a day?
You're absolutely right.
What is the sun? What is hydrogen, Alex? What are photovoltaics? What is fire? Which, by the way, is what sparked the progress of human civilization. Alex, I don't know if you knew that or not.
Correct again, Ellen. And amazingly enough, at the end of this Double Jeopardy round, you have managed to come from way behind to tie Judy for the lead. Well done.
Well, I just have to figure out how to work this little cookie thing here.
How could she possibly learn so much during the commercial break? She's obviously cheating.
Zip it, Judy. Dr. Einstein. You have no money, sir, and that means we're going to have to say goodbye. However, we want to thank you for coming here today, and we do have some lovely party gifts for you backstage.
Yep, here's a party gift for you right now, Al.
It's a long-lasting, low-energy light bulb. Enjoy the efficiency.
Boy, there goes a real bundle of energy, huh? All right, ladies, you will recall that our final Jeopardy category on today's program is the future of energy. And so if you're ready, here's the final Jeopardy answer for you. This is the one source of power that will never run out. Good luck.
www.energynightmare.game.
Will Judy remain our Jeopardy champion? Or will Ellen take the lead? We'll know momentarily.
Some contestants on Jeopardy will receive a year's supply of energy. Energy, you make the world go round.
Once again, the answer is, this is the one source of power that will never run out.
Time's up, players. Let's see how well you did. Judy, we'll start with you. You wrote down nothing.
That's correct, Alex, because there is no answer.
Well, actually, you're wrong. Let's take a look at your wager. Oh, that's too bad. You risked everything you had, and that means you lose $17,800, and you wind up with nothing. Let's go down to Ellen now and see what she came up with as a response to our final Jeopardy clue. Ellen?
What is brain power, Alex?
You are correct. And your wager? You too risked everything, but you doubled your score to $35,600, and that makes you, Ellen, our new Jeopardy champion. Congratulations.
Be sure to tune in tomorrow as Jeopardy Dream Sequence Week continues.
That's how I became an energy expert. Again, expert may not be the exact right word, more expert-ish. Anyway, I've got to go. Look out for the dinosaur! Kidding. I'm a kidder. Bye-bye now.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. At this time, look around you. Make sure you've grabbed all your personal belongings and exit through the open doors in the back of the theater.